to Metals Daily News, brought to you by Metals Update, the driving force behind your business. I'm Kopal Chima from the Mumbai office on 22nd September 2017. In steel and iron ore, as reported by Metals Update earlier, demand for iron ore is expected to weaken in winter due to production cuts in steel factories, while iron ore supply will increase as global miners produce more during the last quarter of the year. However, S&P Global Ratings downgrade of China's long-term sovereign credit rating on Thursday also soured investor sentiment towards commodity futures. The downgrade by S&P, which cited increasing risks from China's rapid buildup of debt, comes less than a month ahead of the twice-a-decade Communist Party Congress. Analysts believe that S&P's move further weakened sentiment towards both commodities already hit by softer demand. Domestically, Supreme Court has allowed auction for Category C iron ore mines in Karnataka. However, the industry experts told media that restrictions placed on bidders during the e-auction will fail to attract players into the region. C-category iron ore mines were last allowed to resume operations after mining operations were banned a few years ago and a cap was subsequently imposed on mining activity in the region. A central empowered committee of the Supreme Court had categorized 166 mining leases into A, B and C as per the extent of illegalities committed by them. Category A comprised of 45 mines that had negligible or no illegalities. Category B comprised of 72 mines where pits were found outside the lease area, and 51 Category C mines were those where operations stretched beyond their lease boundaries by more than 15%. Currently, Karnataka is a closed market and only end users in and around the state can purchase iron ore in the region. The plants can import from other states and outside the country, while the leases cannot export or sell to traders. Moreover, the pricing of iron ore in Karnataka does not follow any international index. In international offers, HMS 1 and 2 FOB Yemen is being offered in the range of $215 to $235 per metric ton. HMS 1 and 2 CFR Turkey is being offered in the range of $250 to $275 per metric ton. HMS 1 and 2 CFR India is being offered in the range of $250 to $275 per metric ton. And HMS 1 and 2 CFR Vietnam is being offered in the range of $250 to $275 per metric ton. In domestic ferrous offers, Metals Update assessed offers of MS scrap from Mandi Gobindgarh market at ₹21,000 per ton, while MS ingot at Mandi Gobindgarh is being quoted at ₹28,800 per ton. At Raipur and Bhavnagar, ingot offers have been recorded at ₹26,300 and ₹27,200 per ton respectively on Friday. In domestic non-ferrous offers, Metals Update assessed spot offers of aluminium ingot from Delhi market at ₹152 per kg. Copper mixed scrap is being offered at ₹370 per kg and tin ingot is being offered at ₹1,370 per kg on Friday. Thank you for watching. Join us again tomorrow for latest updates from the metals market. Visit metalsupdate.com for more information and do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Have a great day ahead.